Hi, I'm Alice Hoffman, an indie comic artist who sometimes also enjoys painting in semi-realism style. Today I'll show you a piece that I came up with as an homework in the mentorship that I am doing with Istebrak. Spoiler alert, you will see an incredible shift in quality once I applied the feedback that I got from her. I started out with 3 rough thumbnails to explore the idea and see which angle might work best. For the final concept, I went with a shot that shows off the lights and scale of the city. I also prepared a reference image board to help with the overall look. I don't have much experience with environment paintings yet, so I started with a 3D base construction in Blender. All in all, it didn't help save a lot of time for this illustration. But it's still good to try new methods every now and then. I think it makes more sense to prepare a 3D model for a location with complex construction or an object that needs to be redrawn from various angles often. I've wanted to finally paint a detailed cityscape for a while. Originally, I was thinking of a typical fantasy setting with a lot of towers and medieval-looking houses. Somehow I ended up with the idea of a girl traveling to an island city that visually reminds of Las Vegas. She wants to start a new, fascinating life there because that seems to be the only place she can make her dreams work out. Maybe she can. Maybe she'll learn some lessons. Who knows? As you can see, I painted in the values first. It is doable to start with colors directly, but that means that there are more things to think about at the same time. When you work with grayscale only, you don't need to look after saturation and hue. It's easier to create a clear focus point that way. A disadvantage might be that it can take a bit longer than painting colors right away, assuming one already knows which colors to pick. For beginners, however, it's a super practical way to create digitally. I did my best to think of a few different building designs. I wanted the main section to look like there are a lot of unique places, all interesting to explore. For other buildings that wouldn't get much viewer attention anyway, I saved time by copy-pasting them. I could have gone way further and created scatter brushes for the window lights. It was totally unnecessary to paint them all manually. In the end, you don't even notice most if you don't specifically look for them. Oh well, sometimes you have to do it the dumb way to realize what works better. This was the first version before I got mentor feedback. I didn't quite hit the mark with the atmosphere, it just wasn't clear enough that this is supposed to be a fun place. It looked too serious and monotonous. It's hilarious how I didn't even think of painting a pier for the boat to target. With paintings that contain a bunch of elements, it's hard to keep the inner logic consistent. That's why it's so important to ask someone you trust for feedback. So, I'd say this got a lot better with the corrections applied. What do you think? Whatever your passion is, make sure to keep challenging yourself. I wish you an excellent day. See you next time. Bye!